Earth is filled with natural sceneries, mighty mountains, vast oceans, turbulent rivers, and deep lakes. There are some places in the world that generate a mythical story around them due to their unusual behavior. But most of the time, there is some scientific explanation behind. There are many such places, such as the Bermuda Triangle, the Great Pyramids, Easter Islands, Stonehenge, etc. We endure their beauty and magnificence. Sometimes we even get into deep thought about the purpose behind their creation. Let us look at some of those places and try to understand the science behind them. My name is Siddharth and you are watching The World of Science. Bermuda Triangle, a vast region of 3,900,000 square kilometers, forms a triangle in the North Atlantic Ocean region with Florida, Bermuda, and Puerto Rico as three vertices. It is also known as the Devil's Triangle. This region is notorious for the disappearance of ships and flights crossing this region. The mention of the triangle first found its place in an article published in the Miami Herald that talked about the sudden disappearances of airplanes there. In December 1952, a torpedo bomber Flight 19 was passing through the triangle and lost contact with the base. All 14 members on the plane were never to be found. The other 13-member crew went to search for the debris, but they were lost too. A 1962 report in an American magazine reported that the pilot was heard saying that sometimes the water is white and next time it turns green. Now here the mystery starts. Many dubbed this report as dubious and the mystery behind it as false conspiracy. Many other cases were reported in the late 90s, but reports were largely exaggerated. In fact, according to Larry Kush, the missing reports were more from other regions than the triangle. But large-scale events happening in the triangular region forces us to find out some of the possible reasons behind the missing. The triangle is the central region through which the hurricane winds enter the USA, and thus it is one of the hardest pathways to cross during a stormy season. The presence of large-scale methane hydrate fields on the continental shelves is also a possible reason. This methane fields, due to their periodic eruption as mud volcanoes, can reduce the density of the sea region drastically, and thus a ship or plane on the water surface can easily be drowned and their remnants may be transported to faraway region from Gulf Stream that travels from Gulf of Mexico to Straits of Florida with a speed of 2 meters per second. These are some of the reasons that led to the disappearance of debris of objects fallen in the sea. Nazca Lines. In the middle of the deserts of Nazca in South Peru, there exist large geoglyphic designs between the barren plateaus. These images are large-scale diagrams of many animals such as birds, spiders, fish, condors, monkeys, dogs, cats, and even humans. They have been dated to be drawn around 500 BC to 500 AD. There are around 80 to 100 figures as large as 400 to 1,100 meters across. Each line has been carved to a depth of 10 to 15 centimeters deep and 25 to 30 centimeters wide. They have been there for around 2000 years. Due to windless, stable climate and protection by high plateaus, they have been left nearly untouched for so long. One may ask, what was the purpose of carving these figures? Most of the researchers agree that these were for religious purposes, drawing figures for the gods above the sky to see them, but many settle for the astronomical interpretations that these figures were astronomical calendars, and they point out to those regions on the horizon where the sun and other planetary bodies rise during the solstices. They can also be interpreted as parallel images drawn to replicate various constellations, like the giant spider can be a representation of the Orion constellation. Some archaeologists believe that these were irrigation channels and drawn as field divisions, but what exactly was the purpose of creativity then? Was it ritualistic, as agriculture too originated from a religiously conscious settling population? Next, we have the Great Blue Hole. You must have seen the image of a great circular dark blue hole near the coast of Mexico in the region of Belize. It is a marine sinkhole formed in a series of thousands of years. This hole is a cave formed of limestone and was carved naturally when the sea level was lower during the period of the Ice Age. When the Ice Age ended, the sea level rose and filled the hole, and its depth caused it to acquire the dark blue texture that we now see. Its diameter is around 318 meters and depth is 124 meters. The hole is filled with aquatic animals and plants up to the depth of 90 meters. But beyond 90 meters, there is a huge presence of hydrogen sulfide, and thus there is no oxygen and no life present beyond this region. The Great Blue Hole is a part of the Great Belize Coral Barrier Reef ecosystem and is quite a fascinating place to visit, or even dive if you're brave enough. Darwaza Crater. This place is called the Gateway to Hell. Located in the Karakum Desert of Turkmenistan, this place has now become a tourist destination, and the orange-reddish flames constantly burning in the cave give a mythical picture of a gateway to hell. The diameter of the caverne is 69 meters and its depth is 30 meters. This was an oil field site, and when Turkmenistan was part of the Soviet Union, the Soviets decided to set up a drilling rig in the area, but soon they discovered that there was a natural gas pocket around the region. This pocket collapsed and formed a cave in the ground from which the poisonous gases started coming out. The Soviets, fearing the spread of poisonous methane gas, decided to burn the cave. They thought that all the fuel would be burned down in a few weeks. It was 1971 when it was discovered, and it is still burning and will continue to burn for many long years. Was it really a devil's work? Atlantis. Okay, there may not be any real place like Atlantis, but this mythical city has been the inspiration of multiple legends and stories all around the world, and some even agree that there must have been such a place that became mythical in Plato's works. The story of Atlantis comes from the Greek philosopher Plato's work Timaeus. Contrary to the popular belief, according to Plato, Atlantis was the place of anti-heroes. They were a great naval power who besieged the ancient Republic of Athens, but Athenians won the war and gods were very furious at Atlanteans, so they cursed them, and thus Atlantis was submerged under the sea. This led Plato to conclude that his system of republic that was prevalent in Athens was a better system of governance that gave them superiority over Atlantis. The story of Atlantis, according to Plato, happened some 9,000 years before him. Now, this dating places the event of Atlantis close to the last ice age. Ice was melting after the end of the ice age and sea levels were rising. This led many researchers to believe that the story of Atlantis may be inspired by a real-life event that happened during the last Ice Age epoch. Many such islands such as Sardinia, Sicily, Cyprus, Malta have been proposed as the possible sites of legendary Atlantis. Some even consider that inside the Bermuda Triangle, this mythical island is present. In the 6th century BC, there was a big volcanic eruption known as the Thera eruption that generated a huge tsunami. This tsunami devastated Crete Island in Greece, on which the Minoan civilization was established. This event is the most accepted theory of Atlantis' story to emerge. The date and location are close to the era of Plato too. Multiple such places exist all around the world. Pyramids, crop circles, temples, caves provide us with the information of how ancients perceived the world and made sense out of it. Mythologies were developed to propagate philosophy to the masses. A pyramid can be a tomb for Pharaoh and also a physical representation of the belt of Orion on Earth. It depends upon you, which interpretation you find logical. What are your thoughts about these mysterious places and possible logics behind them? Let us know in the comments. If you found this video interesting, please leave a thumbs up and share it with your friends. Check out our new Hindi channel from the description below. Do follow us on Instagram for daily quality content that'll make you fall in love with science. Comment down the topics that you want us to cover in our next videos. Make sure you subscribe to the World of Science. Until next time, stay scientific.